Now, tonight's guest is a very menschy girl. We've been trying to do the topic of modeling for a couple of years now. And quite frankly, Rebecca's the first model with a good enough sense of humor to answer the call. She hosts MTV's House of Style and appears in the new movie Austin Powers, The Spy Who Shagged Me. Please welcome Rebecca Romijn Stamos, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Okay.
You said everything I was
going to
say.
Yeah?
Yeah, so,
oh, no.
Goodbye.
I have to ask you, if John Stamos were named John Lettuce, would you have, in fact, hyphenated your last name?
Interesting question. Yes.
My well was dry when I asked that question.
That's it.
Hey, now, I have to tell you, I saw this swimsuit model, making of the swimsuit model issue.
Mm-hmm.
And you were very funny at the end. Was that a good time for you?
I don't know if anybody saw it, but
on the whole convention of modeling.
Well, I've done that issue 5 times. I've done that special 5 times now, and I couldn't bear to answer those same stupid questions that they always ask you in that thing seriously one more time. And it's always the same questions. Is it important to have chemistry with the photographer? Is it important to be on the cover? Of course it's important to be on the cover of the magazine. Same questions over and over every year. So John and I actually wrote that together and decided that I said I wasn't going to do it unless I could kind of
do
it. She
played overly petulant.
Yeah, I was a total bitch. But actually it's funny because some people thought I was serious. Like some people actually,
I got messages. Shit for brains.
Yeah, and
been more
I decided
over the top,
that that's become my gauge, my indicator on whether or not I want to know someone. If you thought I was serious on there, I don't care to know you.
Yeah, I mean that's a bad miss because it couldn't have been more broad, or well, not as broad as Austin Powers, which,
right,
by the way, must have been a great time.
So
I saw
fun.
This premiere the other night. You've got a flock to
and
this movie.
And I was looking for you. I heard you were there, and I was looking for you.
Oh God, I was just out of my mind with laughter. And you know what? Mini-Me was in front of me. Have you seen this guy? Oh, he's the cutest guy. I had an angle on him. He's right in front of me. And it was the most beautiful thing because, obviously that small, I would think the guy would have had to have had a bit of an odd life. I mean, it must be,
right.
He is so tiny. He's like this. And he was standing on his chair looking up at the screen. And I could see him bathed in that movie light. And every time he'd come on, he had the biggest smile on his face. I'm sitting there at a comedy fucking crying about Mini-Me, It was so beautiful.
But didn't he actually look bigger in the movie? Obviously it's a huge screen, but I mean, like, he's only about
he is tiny. If this guy wins an Oscar, he's going to bring a forklift.
He's
the funniest movie.
He's
you gotta
the smallest
go
person I've ever seen. And he had his little friend with him. Did you see that?
His little friend wasn't little. That's what I mean. He cruised in with St. Charisse. A big girlfriend.
Rumor has it that Vern gets a lot of women.
Really?
Like, regular. So yeah, that's what I've been hearing around town.
Not all of them's Mini-Me. Okay. you hear these. Well, first off, there's so many archetypes of modeling. But first, when you go back to the big model dorm later tonight.
Where we all hang out.
Yeah.
In our lair.
And everybody's sitting around in their PJs in front of the fire having s'mores.
In our panties.
Yeah. You've got to tell them to quit saying they were never pretty when they were young, because that's the one thing that drives
people crazy.
Isn't that
annoying? I know. And I have to say that I'm guilty of that because I was the geeky teenager and the gawky.
We're all geeky teenagers. Who's David Niven when they're 12?
Right. I know. We got to stop saying that.
Yeah, it's a bad one.
It's
I think
obnoxious.
That's one of the ones people go, oh, shut up.
All right.
We're all kind of fucked
up. Yeah, you're right. I'm going to pass that along to all the models.
It's a big model arc out there. We had two of every type. But I would say this. When you hear how hard it is, there are a lot of jobs. I do believe that part of it is hard, I do believe there are long hours, but it's not as hard as some things.
It's not.
But I'll tell you what is hard. I think it's irresponsible when some of these parents let these kids split at age 14.
Younger. I mean, when I left for Paris when I was 18, I was a college student. I was only going to do it for the summer. And I didn't want to be a model in the first place, and they convinced me to stay. They said, we'll take really good care of you, we'll get you some really amazing jobs, which they did. So they kind of, they kept going. But I met these 13, 14-year-olds who were practically illiterate. They left school. Their parents let them move to Paris on their own so they could say, hey, my daughter's a glamorous model living in Europe, I guess. And what happens is these agencies promise these parents that they'll be chaperoned and well taken care of in Europe. And they're not. They get to Paris and they get placed in these model apartments with tons of other models. And there are all these, you know, greasy, fat playboys with the phone numbers to the model apartments. Yeah. And they call them up and they take them out to dinner and they schmooze and they can't wait to get them drunk. And these girls just get sucked in. They're young. They look like they're 25. They're being treated like they're 25. And they've got money on them. And they've got no curfew. And they go crazy.
You know what? When you think about it that way... I think it's criminal what these parents do, that they don't like to wake up. That blows my mind that you've got...
Parents should know what's really going on, because it is sad, have to say.
Well, you know, when a father has a daughter who's 14, he's not that far removed from being the greasy creep. You know what I mean? Guess... You'd think he'd remember that...
Right. Because most of these guys are, you know, older than the fathers.
But you say your experience was never like this. It was kind of easier for you.
I don't know. I mean, I have to say that as far as the drug scene was concerned, nobody ever offered me drugs. I remember reading that Michael Gross book about supermodels with Tyra Banks, and I were reading part of it together, and they were going on and on about all the drugs and all the, you know, these models taking drugs. And she looks at me and she's like, Becca, did anybody ever offer you drugs on a job? And I was like, nope. What about you? And she goes, no, me neither. She goes, what's wrong with us? Like, we were like the model nerds or something that everyone kind of ignored.
She call you Becca?
Yeah.
That's so hot. What is the biggest misconception that people have about models? Now, I know the pat line is that they're all dumb, but I can't imagine anybody who travels, they must be savvy in some way,
yeah,
right?
You know what? It's true. Models get a bad rap for being dumb. I have to say, for the most part, models are, I haven't met that many really dumb models. I mean, they've traveled the world. It's true. I hate to say it. I know it's silly. It's a silly cliche. But they read books on the plane all the time. They've seen everything. Stop laughing.
But you see, I'm convinced that nervous sort of titter
is
predicated on the fact that I don't think anybody in this whole world cops to the fact of how important looks are. There's this whole bullshit thing going on that we're all in it for our souls and our minds. And yeah, I'd like to believe that in the overview, but I don't know. It seems to me that looks are equally valid in this world to some degree. People get an easier life sometimes.
Well, and
when
that's why, you know, models get such a bad rap, is because they've gotten by on their looks for so long. But a lot of these girls speak tons of languages. They hang out with mostly older people, and so they've got kind of an interesting perspective on things and interesting stories to tell, and they've seen the entire world. So, you know, they do get a bad rap, but it's true. I mean, they have skated by on their looks. And then at the same time, they don't see anything after their career, you know, their modeling career ends at 25, and they don't understand the world yet, so they don't see anything past 25. Like, they think their world
right,
is over.
That's the, that's the horizon line. Listen, here's something I've always wanted to know. Does Jose Bear ever take off that shitty little hat?
I don't know, that's a mystery. Big.
What is that hat?
I don't know.
You cannot say you're bald more than wearing that hat. You'd be better off just bumping your head up like a bowling ball. And people would notice you were bald, Lex. And every time I see him, he's got that little hat on. And Scabulo, too. Take the hats off, boys. The gig's up. We know you're bald. We've got phone calls for you. Line 4, we've got Gary from Huntsville, Alabama. Gary?
Hey. What's happening, Rebecca?
Hey, Gary.
Hey, you're looking very pretty tonight.
Thank you, Gary.
What am I, a jaguar?
No, you look great, Dennis.
Hey, okay, you can call me Becca.
Okay, Becca. How about Jenna?
Go ahead.
But anyway, my question is for Rebecca, is that why do you hear a lot of super duper models are always dating these rock stars that treat them like crap? Why is that?
Gluttons for punishment. I don't know.
I didn't hear the question. They have men who treat them like crap?
Why do they date guys?
That's just a young girl's thing.
Yeah,
I mean,
girls do that.
Let's face facts. There's going to be plenty of time for women who look like that later in life to meet a nice guy. And when they're young, they're like dangerous guys. That's just the way the world works. Gary, are you dangerous?
Well, no, I'm not necessarily dangerous, but I just wondered why they don't necessarily, like, date a plumber or something.
Gary,
you can't figure that out yourself.
I mean, I'm not one. I'm a computer.
Oh, we didn't think you were a plumber, yeah.
No, I know.
Although already sound a little clogged up. Line 9, we've got Josh from Chester, South Carolina. Josh?
How you doing?
What's happening down there in South Carolina tonight, Josh?
Not a whole lot.
All right.
Rebecca, I just want to say that I think you're the most gorgeous model on the face of this earth, and there's no other model just as gorgeous as you. I just think you're...
Thank you, Josh.
Do you have any pants on, Josh? You're way down south in South Carolina. What's your question, Josh?
You want a groovy baby? Yeah, baby, yeah, baby!
Is that a question? What?
Yeah, that was Josh's question. All right, Josh, thanks for touching in. Wow, why do I get the feeling he called in on a dial phone? All right, now I hate to ask you the age-old question, but I did see you have a little snippet in Austin Powers. It's more of a cameo than an acting job, but would you like to do that Heather Graham thing? Do you want to do that, or is modeling enough for you? Or you seem happy with your old man, right? He seems like a good guy.
Yeah, I'll see. No, I mean, you know.
Did he hate those twins, or did he get along with them?
Oh, the twins. Right.
You know, Jimmy Olsen twins.
You know how our career progresses. I mean, it'll go in that direction or it won't. I mean, things kind of come up. We'll see what happens.
Well, you know, the best thing you got going for you is, I mean, anybody who begrudges you, because every time I see you, yeah, yeah. The way you should act about things like this.
You can't take yourself too seriously. That's the one thing. I mean, this business is so superficial and so silly. And that's the one thing is I see these models who believe their own hype, and they're so stupid.
Yeah, the way I look at it, anybody in our side of this business is kind of cosmic wave. You know, you ride it till it peters out on the shore. You go to the cabana, go home, and play some jumble in the newspaper.
Exactly.
You know, that's all you got going. Rebecca, thanks for coming on. Let's get her hand on the news.